been a long time since I talked about a TV show on here, hasn't it? It's been football, it's been wrestling, and it's been, well, busy. Really busy. So today, I'm going to take the brief period of time I've got smushed in here where I'm not going to talk about football and wrestling, and I want to talk about a show that. So I don't get to watch a lot of TV during the hockey season. I watch all the hockey games, and then before I go to bed, I watch usually Stephen Colbert. That's about all I got time for. Sometimes I watch The Daily Show with Trevor Noah. Sometimes I choose between the two. Sometimes I choose one or the other. But in general, that's pretty much all I get to watch. So network TV shows that I enjoy, they kind of get all backed up, and then I binge watch them all after the season is over, when the season is over. So when the TV season is over is normally when the hockey season's over, and then I get to binge watch my favorite shows. So I get way behind. But I try to make sure I'm watching the news and stay keeping up on that, because you don't have to worry about coming into the news on a Wednesday and going, "Well, I don't understand this because I didn't see Tuesday's episode of the news. What happened yesterday?" So I don't really have to worry about that, although we're getting there. But I decided, I'm going to try something different because it's a half an hour show. And over a month ago, my wife and I tried watching A Little Late with Lilly Singh. Now, Lilly Singh, for people who may not know, multi-million subscriber count on YouTube. She's a big YouTube celebrity star, and she gets her own show, and she's a visible minority. You may know this within the first joke of every single monologue she does. And I get it. I do, but let it go. Just find something else to talk about. She's already been in some controversy for making light of turbans, which I thought was, eh. I don't know. Here's the thing: I didn't find anything she said in that moment offensive. I just didn't find it funny. I didn't find it funny, and I've tried, and I've been amazed at some of the guests she has on there. Like, she has some really, really good guests, but I find her very off-putting, and. This is where it gets weird. So people will say, "Well, Shannon, it's not really for you. It's for a different audience." Well, shouldn't television, shouldn't your nightly show, shouldn't your late night show, shouldn't that be for everybody? And the thing is that this isn't just, "Oh, Shannon doesn't get it because he's a white guy," because I enjoyed the Chappelle show. That wasn't really designed for me. I enjoyed most of Eddie Murphy's work in the 80s, even when it was highly geared towards people that weren't me. I have enjoyed drug humor, even though I've never used drugs. I have enjoyed, and it depends on who's doing it. One of my favorite comedians of all time is George Carlin, who often talked about things that I may have had no experience with, but he was very funny. Now, my favorite comedian of all time is still, and may God rest his soul, John Panette. John Panette could tell the exact same shtick over and over and over, and you can watch it 15 times and still laugh at it. And he only had a very limited amount of actual bits that he did, but they were really, really funny. And he seemed like a very genuine, very nice person. So when he would tell jokes, you found yourself saying, "This is a guy I could hang out with. This he seems like a very nice guy. I didn't swear." Every now and then there'd be a swear word here and there, but it's not like his show was curse filled or anything. And he didn't get into politics, and he didn't get into controversial topics. He would do like 10 minutes about the guarantee from Best Buy and how useless it was, and it was genuinely really funny. Or guarantees on toasters, like just things that during the day you might find ridiculous, that he would take it then and ad nauseum he'd draw it out. Every joke Lilly Singh has told, and I have watched this show for over a month. I have tried. So this is not, "Oh, Shannon watched it once and said, forget it." I have tried because it's only half an hour, and it's after a show I'm watching anyway, so I'm like, "Yeah, I'll give it a shot." And it's not funny. And it's not funny. I haven't laughed at a single joke she's told. I haven't smiled at a single joke. It has been just bad. So here's my challenge, for you, the fine viewers out there. If you've seen it, And if you found it funny, can you tell me how? And it's got 100% on Rotten Tomatoes, which once again proves that Rotten Tomatoes is becoming less and less reliable as time goes on. So I went on to Rotten Tomatoes and gave it 1 star because it's bad. And I'm surprised it's as high as 47%, but apparently her YouTube subscribers have been going in and trying to prop up that score because it was much lower than that. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Again, this is something a little different, just dropping it in there, a little bit different, something that this channel has covered before, and getting to that. Hit like and subscribe if you're browsing ways for you just happened upon this video. And again, not saying that nobody finds it funny, just I personally don't find any of it anywhere at all funny. Let me know your thoughts. Thank you guys so much for subscribing and for your support. And yes, this is a Futurama jersey, and I'm very proud of it. Thanks for your support. I'll talk to you again soon.